Hi, this is Dinesh with the Firewall BU, and in this video, we'll look at the device templates, a new feature introduced in release 7.6.0. This feature brings in the capability to templatize the firewall configuration and provide scalable and convenient rollout of the branch devices in your SD-WAN environment. This is achieved by bringing in a new device templates feature natively within the FMC UI. So device templates is a bundle of device configuration and policies where you can have parameterized configuration. All the interfaces, the network objects, and the gateways can be configured either using the variables and the network object overrides that we'll look in the next slides. And device templates supports pre-provisioning day zero configuration as well as day two operational configuration. The device templates supports multiple FTD hardware and software version and all the device configuration that is used during the device initialization is supported, including the shared policies and the VPN topology. Now let's consider a deployment where we have firewall management center that manages a couple of branch devices. Now this feature allows an admin to pre-provision day zero configuration using the templates, which supports interface for the device initialization, routing and DHCP for the LAN and WAN connectivity, the VPN for the VPN access to the hub and other branch sites, the policies, which are additional security policies and the device policies. Once the device template is created, FMC creates a copy of this template in the backend, and in the next step, the copy of the configuration is pushed to the branch devices. This provides a similar configuration experience to the admin as when you onboard a device during the registration. And this also supports day two operations like NAT, QoS, Zero Trust, platform settings, and flex config policies. Configuration workflow comprises of three steps. In the first step, we create a template either from the scratch or generated from an existing device or exported from an existing template. In the next step, we configure the policies and define the variables and the network object overrides and define the interface mapping. Variables is a new object type, which is a placeholder for inline values in the supported configuration. In the last step, the device template is applied to multiple devices and supports variables that can be defined per device to configure various configuration attributes on the firewall. In terms of prerequisites, this is an FMC-only feature which requires FMC to be on 7.6 version and above. The firewall threat defense requires to be on 7.4.1 and above, and the hardware that is supported with the device template is 1000 series, 2100 series, and 3100 series firewall. No additional licenses are required to create and configure the device templates, and only the target devices must have the license entitlement for their respective features. In this demo, we'll use a branch firewall, which is dual ISP and is managed through the data interface on the outside one. So we'll start with creating the device template, which includes defining the interfaces, the routing configuration, the DHCP configuration for the LAN network pool, the policy-based routing for the direct internet access, and VPN topology for the branch-to-hub communication. The second step is where we apply the template during the registration, and lastly, we will create a template from an existing device. So let's start with creating the device template by navigating to template management within the devices. We click on Add Device Template and give this template a name. And the only other thing we need to define is the access control policy. And we notice the creation of the template is in progress. And once it is successful, we edit and look at all the options available within the template. Because this device is managed through the data interface, so we navigate to template settings and change the setting for Manage Device by Data Interface. Click OK to acknowledge, and then we pivot to Interfaces to add additional physical interface for our Outside 2 interface. So let's edit the Ethernet 1/1. We give it name Outside 1, define the security zone, and verify the IP addressing. Then we enable path monitoring and enable manager access to manage device via the Outside 1 interface. Ethernet 1/2 is used as the inside or LAN interface, so we define the inside zone. And this is where we create a variable for the inside interface. This is a placeholder for the inline values that we will configure during the template apply. Click OK, and now let's designate the ETH 1/3 interface as the outside 2. So we give it a name, enable the interface, and map it to the security zone outside. Similarly, we configure another variable which will be used to define the IP on this interface during the template apply. We enable the path monitoring for the policy-based routing. And this completes our interface configuration. Additionally, you can configure inline sets through the templates as well. Now, within the routing, we will create three static routes. The first static route is for the internet access through the outside 2 interface. So we define a particular gateway, which is the outside 2 gateway. Note that this object has been created with allow overrides enabled. That allows us to configure the value particular to a specific branch device. So let's create another route where we add a route towards the inside interface for the SNMP server. And we configure the gateway as the SNMP server gateway. This SNMP server is part of the platform settings. And another route for the inside interface. Now within DHCP, we can enable the DHCP server. So let's enable the auto configuration so that we can get the configuration from the outside one. Enable the DHCP server on the inside, and we define another variable for the DHCP pool. We have additional configuration options for the DHCP relay and DDNS. And then we pivot to the VPN topology mapping. So we already have a VPN topology, and we are adding this branch device as a spoke. So we define the VPN interface and the public IP and create a local IK ID. Within the routing, we can also configure the policy-based routing configuration. In this example, we're routing Splunk through the interface with the minimum round trip time and the WebEx application through the interface with the minimum packet loss. So now that we're done with the configuration, we go to the template settings and define the licensing for this device and also define additional policies which can be pushed to the devices using this template. Within the template parameters, this is where we see the variables that we created, and we add those network object overrides that we used earlier in the configuration. So now we pivot to the model mapping. This is to map template interfaces to the targeted FTD interfaces or the available FTD model interfaces. So we'll start with the Firepower 1010 device and map it to the default interfaces. Additionally, if you're using outside 2 interface on a different interface, you can call that as well. So we click on save. And similarly, we map another firewall that is 3105 to this template. Now let's save the template. Now we pivot to the device to register itself to the FMC. Once the configure manager is done, we go to the second step of applying template during the registration. So we click on add device using wizard and we'll use registration key. We select the branch template and now we define the device attributes. So we'll start with the display name, the registration key and the unique NAT ID. And because we're using NAT ID, we don't need to define the host. And this is where we define all the variables that we defined earlier in the template. So we'll give the values for the variables like DHCP pool, inside interface and outside interface, and the branch local ID, along with the network object overrides. So let's click on add device. And notice that the device registration has started. Now, this is divided into three steps. The first step is the discovery phase. So once the registration is done, we'll start with the discovery phase. Once the device discovery phase is complete, we pivot to apply phase. This is where the template apply starts. Notice that the device template application is complete and we have a report which actually gives us more details about the kind of attributes or the configuration parameters which were pushed to a particular device. And this brings us to the third phase, which is the deploy phase. Now that the template apply has completed, now we're deploying that configuration to the device NY47. Notice that the policy deployment is successful. Because we are using FTD1 as the hub device for the VPN topology, we'll go and configure that as well. And now notice that all the interface configuration or the routing configuration that we did in the device template has been pushed to the branch NY47. Similarly, we notice that we have DHCP server configuration as well on this branch device. Now, if we pivot to the site-to-site VPN topology, notice that now the spoke section has been updated by the VTI interface, which was configured by the virtue of the device template. Now let's edit the template that we created and navigate to associated devices. This is where we can see the apply status and the sync status for the device that was onboarded. If there's any configuration change on the device or in the template after it was applied, this will show as out of sync. Now, we go to the third step, which is creating template from the existing device. So we edit the device and click on generate template from device. Give it a name and click OK. Once we acknowledge the message, notice that in the task, the device template creation has started. Once the device template creation is successful, we can navigate to devices template management and validate the device template that we created in the last step. This concludes our demo, and I hope this was informative.